Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' Physics.
Ladies and gentle people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seat, ready and excited to learn about uniformly accelerated motion.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Oh boy.
Uniformly accelerated motion. An object in UAM, or uniformly accelerated motion, is an object that is moving with an acceleration that is uniform. An acceleration is constant. An acceleration that is equal to a number, and that number does not change. There are all sorts of objects that are in uniformly accelerated motion, or UAM. You could have, for example, a ball rolling down an incline. Person falling from a plane. A bicycle on which you have applied the brakes. A ball being dropped from the top of a ladder. Or even a toy baby bottle being released from the bottom of a bath. All of these are examples of objects experiencing uniformly accelerated motion. Yes, I know there is friction. I know the incline isn't perfectly constant. I know that the air exists. I know that the water is actually going to apply a large drag force. I also know that the brakes aren't going to apply a perfectly constant braking force. Therefore, none of these examples are perfectly uniformly accelerated motion. But we could also talk about the fact that we live in a non-constant gravitational field, that the bike is actually traveling on the surface of the planet, which is the shape of a sphere, which means it's a non-Euclidean surface. We could also talk about the fact that traveling, you can spell with one or two L's, but none of this is stuff that we're going to talk about today, because it's close enough. All of these examples are very close to uniformly accelerated motion, and therefore, we can consider it, for the purposes of this class, for all of them to be uniformly accelerated motion. Okay?
Who is he talking to?
I don't know. I didn't think anybody else was here.
Peanut Gallery. Have you guys never seen the Peanut Gallery?
All right, moving on. Here are the equations that describe an object moving in uniformly accelerated motion. There are four UAM equations. I have written them right here. I'm now going to walk my way through each one of the equations. Velocity final is equal to velocity initial plus the acceleration times a change in time. Displacement is equal to velocity initial times a change in time plus 1/2 times the acceleration times a change in time squared. Velocity final squared is equal to velocity initial squared plus 2 times the acceleration times the displacement. And the change in position is equal to 1/2 times the quantity velocity final plus velocity initial, that quantity multiplied by the change in time. Bobby, there are 5 variables. Could you please identify all 5 variables in these 4 equations?
Okay, let's see. There's velocity final and velocity initial. Acceleration, what else? Change in time and delta x.
Words, not letters.
Yeah, that's a change in displacement.
Delta x is displacement, not change in displacement.
The last one is displacement or change in position.
Thanks, Bo.
You're welcome.
Yes, the 5 variables are velocity final, velocity initial, acceleration, change in time, and displacement, or delta x, which means to change in position, because delta means change in and x means position. Now, one thing that I do suggest when you use the UAM equations is that you always use base SI dimensions or meters and seconds. Now, it's not actually mandatory, but I find that students make many fewer mistakes when they use meters and seconds in the UAM equations. Every once in a while, you don't have to, but for the purposes of this class, we are always going to use meters and seconds. Now, the way it works is this. If you know 3 out of the 5 UAM variables, you can actually figure out the other 2 unknown variables. So,
Here's how it works. Everybody ready?
Yeah. Sure.
Ready for what?
Class, there are how many uniformly accelerated motion variables?
Five.
Okay, let's try that again. Class, there are how many uniformly accelerated motion variables?
Five.
And there are how many UAM equations?
Four.
And if you know how many of the variables?
Three.
You can figure out the other?
Two.
Which leaves you with one?
Answer?
Not answer. Turns out that because there are actually two unknown variables, you could actually have more than one answer. So what you actually are left with is one happy physics student.
Ugh. That's me?
Yeah. All right, one more time. There are how many UAM variables?
Five.
And there are how many UAM equations?
Four.
And if you know how many of the UAM variables?
Three.
You can figure out the other
two.
Which leaves you with one
happy physics student.
Yeah.
That's right. One happy physics student. In our next lecture, we're going to go through and work through a problem, an example problem having to do with uniformly accelerated motion. I hope you enjoyed learning with me today, class. I enjoyed learning with you.
Lecture notes are available at flippingphysics.com. Please enjoy lecture notes responsibly.